Love and light. So, since I have a good bit of Bashar material, and I have a lot of Bashar fans coming to my channel, since I'm a Bashar fan also, and I support his work, and also under this same topic would be the Law of One, which I also am a fan of and support that work also. I find it resonates with me, anyways. But there is some controversy about Bashar and Darryl Anka. There are some who are saying that, first of all, there are other people channeling Bashar besides Darryl Anka. And as far as I understand, some of these people, Darryl Anka has approved, or he has acknowledged that they are indeed channeling Bashar. Bashar has allowed this, or they are channeling someone else of the Esasani. But then there are some who are taking that to a step further by trying to say they are now channeling Bashar and Darryl Anka is not, because Darryl Anka is not. Because of the monetary aspect, because of the fact that Bashar's videos are still monetized and not put out freely, there are some saying, well, Bashar should be channeling. Bashar wants all this stuff put out freely, and Darryl Anka and his team are not agreeing to that. So that Bashar is now channeling through other people. Okay. Personally, I don't see how this could be possible, because Bashar is Darryl Anka's higher self. It is one of his future selves, and in a sense, it is his higher self. They are the same being. I don't really understand how anyone is going to try to take over Bashar from Darryl Anka when it is him. It is an expression of his higher self. He has tried to distance himself from Bashar in a sense, or keep the identity separate so that Bashar's message can come through purely on its own. But the truth is, Darryl Anka is intimately connected to Bashar. And I would also like to mention there are several people today channeling Ra from the Law of One. They are channeling the Ra Collective. And while it may be true that there may be multiple people who have contacted the Ra Collective at some level, but and I don't, unfortunately, I don't remember exactly where I read this because I've studied the Law of One material, all the volumes, and some of the other books, and some of the transcripts, and the multiple sessions of the Kuo sessions and the Hatan sessions, and there are lots of other sessions. It is a huge body of knowledge. I've not gotten through it all, of course, but I've read a lot more than the actual just Law of One books. And somewhere in there, I don't remember exactly where, but more than once, first of all, they talk about look how much detail they went through. Look how meticulous they were in the body arrangements and the group settings and the energy settings, all to get that one channel ready to receive their energy in a clear, undistorted way. They were incredibly specific about those things. And yet we have people now channeling Ra by theirself with just covering their eyes or doing something like that. And I'm not saying in any way that these people are disingenuous. I don't know. I'm just saying that I don't see how you can trust the information coming through one person who is not trained to be accurate when Ra themselves said they would never come through. And that's the other thing that I recall somewhere reading in there that Ra said they would never come through one person, like that, without the group, without the verification of the group. For one thing, they didn't think one person would be able to handle their energy. And Carla Rucker and Don Elkins, some of these people got severely sick from channeling Raw, from the amount of energy it was holding. It caused them physical damage, and I believe they said they were not going to come through anyone else after the Raw material, any other group. No, I'm not sure, but so for me, I'm not going to listen to someone channel Raw when there is literally countless volumes of Raw material channeled from the original approved people and collective and group that was working with them. Why would we then go to listen to someone channeling Raw outside of that group with a different message? It seems suspicious to me, but. Any case, everyone has to follow their own heart and resonance. But for me, I'm going to stick with the original Raw material, and I'm going to stick with Daryl Anka as the transmission for Bashar. So I'm going to stick with Don Elkins and all those people and Carla Records, LL Research. If I want to hear Raw, I'm going to stick with Daryl Anka. If I want to hear Bashar, I'm not going to, you know, I've tried to contact Bashar myself. I personally feel that I made contact with Bashar or some kind of energy like Bashar's. Maybe it was Esasani, I don't know. But that was something personal for me. That was a message that came through. I'm not going to come on here and claim that I'm channeling Bashar. You know? That's ridiculous. His lower self is on Earth. He has an incarnation on Earth, fully capable of transmitting his message. Yeah. We all have our own higher selves, too. Like, I feel like people are trying to take, to live under Bashar or Ra, to live under their divinity and grace instead of finding their own. Because we all have a higher self also. Yes, Bashar is unique and amazing. Yes, he's amazing. But so are we. So is everyone else. No one needs to copy anyone. All right. Love and light.